told, to make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, come before his presence and singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he who hath made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates into thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. And be thankful to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. I'm going to leave the subject being thankful. In today's time, I heard a whole lot of complaining and not enough thinking. Everybody complaining about this, complaining about that. But we ought to be thankful that we here and we have another day just to tell God thank you.
Amen.
And have an opportunity to get our life together.
That's right. Amen.
Verse 1, we are told to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Okay, let's break this down. First, there's the word make. This word means to make music.
Okay.
It is used to refer to singing and to the song.
Alright.
Then there's the word joyful. This word means to give a public confession of the works of God.
Amen.
Thirdly, there is the word noise. This word means to raise a shout.
Come on,
it refers to a ringing cry.
Come on, sir.
A cry that pierces the eardrum.
Yeah.
And when all these things are put together, we can see that the psalms is calling on the people of the Lord to raise an anthem of praise from their hearts to the Lord.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is a challenge to participate in the public praise of God's people and works.
Yeah.
Psalms 41 through 3 tells us what the Lord did for us when he saved us. These verses tell us that he put a new song in my mouth.
Yeah.
No longer was I singing after the word. And all it offered now I was singing to the Lord who saw me and brought me and brought me out.
Yeah.
The right spirit is a spirit of shouting.
Yeah.
Remember, genuine praise is always vocal, visible, and public.
That's right.
No glory when, but like whenever we hold it in. This word serve means, in verse 2, it means to be in bondage to.
Yeah.
It refers to doing whatever the master tells the slave to do.
Yeah. Come on now.
It means to be at his beck and call.
Yeah.
Never we got saved, we became the Lord's property.
Right.
Therefore,
right.
We ought to do what he tells us to do.
That's
right. Our question, our hesitation.
Right.
Some folks don't like it already.
They
don't like anyone telling them what to do.
Right.
Well, if you didn't like that, then you ain't gonna like this neither.
Yeah.
Tell us that we ought to serve him with gladness.
Yes,
this
right.
Is the word gladness means with mirror.
Come on, sir.
This is a word that we don't use as much in our modern time, but it means gladness with laughter.
Yeah.
This verse is telling us that we ought to serve the Lord with laughter. We should be so filled with love for him that regardless of what he asks us to do, we are tickled to death to do it.
That's right.
This is the attitude that filled David's heart in Psalm 21.
Come on, sir.
He said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. He was filled with mirth whenever it was time to go to church. The word gladness is a dictionary word. It carries with the meaning of being wide-eyed with a big grin.
That's right.
It brings to mind to me of a child that's they have a whole lot of joy. Like when something happens that they like, it affects the whole body.
That's right.
The mouth flies open, the eyes open wide, the face lights up, the heart lifts, and the soul rejoices. Such should be a great pleasure for us as we come to serve the Lord, our God, who has redeemed us from death and healed by his precious blood. We ought to do this with gladness, not shame.
That's right.
And there are times whenever I come to church and you feel like I'm at a funeral.
Yeah.
But we ought to come here and thank God we've been forgiven and allowed God to go and came back from the dead on the third appointed one. And then the second part of verse 2 tells us we ought to approach the Lord with singing. This little word refers again to the ringing cry, the shout of joy. Our hearts should be so filled with the wonder of who he is and what he has done for us that we allow his praises to burst forth from our inner being.
Yeah.
Yeah.
These first two verses tell us that when God is in your life, you will not be able to hide him. That's what was telling us in Sunday school. You will not keep him a secret for very long. You can't have someone the size of God in your heart without letting him burst forth.
Sometimes
run out your eyes.
Yeah.
Sometimes he'll show up and raise your hands.
Yeah.
And sometimes he'll run up in your throat and open your vocal cords and make you shout.
Come on, man. Come on.
The fact is, you will not be able to hide him.
That's right.
Verse 3 tells us we are his people.
Yeah.
We are not our own. Everything that is on this earth comes from him, even us.
That's right.
Even our problems. So whatever is wrong, take it to the Lord.
There you go. Preach now.
Verse 4 tells us that
we are given an invitation to come into his presence. Yeah. We are told at these gates, gates are defensive weapons and our usual clothes to all outsiders. Mm. However, through the blood of Jesus, we are no longer the enemies of God, but now we are sons of God.
Yeah.
The gates which were once closed to us are open wide, and we are begging to enter into his presence, God, and we bring to him the sacrifice of praise for our salvation. Next, we are invited to enter into his courts with praise. Note that we are not just asked to the outer members of his sanctuary, but we are invited to walk into the throne room, where we can meet him in all of his glory. Last point, and I'm closing. We are to bless his name. Why should we bless his name? We should bless his name because the Lord is good, and he loves us. What if he was bad? And what if he hated us? He put up with our nasty attitudes.
Come
he put
now,
up with our complaints.
Come on.
I'm so glad that it says his mercy never lasts.
Come on,
and we praise God because he is constantly extending his mercy to us as we go through